job now, I get the, I didn't do it.
And what do you say?
I say, yep, I know you didn't. Case a little bit, you being a making boy and all.
What do you think?
I'm just glad I chose law and not order. Big mess in trial like that, even if you was innocent, a lot of what happened can't ever be undone. I got a nephew up at UGA. You teach there long?
Going on the 6th year.
You meet your wife in Athens? You want to know how I see it?
Sure.
Regardless, could be you just married the wrong woman. Stop going on about how he didn't do it. He was an older fella, big soft eyes behind a pair of smart motor glasses. He just wailing back there. Says it wasn't him. Crying and snotting all over right where you sit. Then before long, he starts kicking the back of the seat like a fussy baby on an airplane. And I tell him he's gotta stop. That's government property, and I'll be forced to zap him otherwise. So he stops, and having exhausted all his options, he starts crying out for his mama. Mama, it's all a big mistake. It wasn't me.
So did he do it?
They caught the fucker red-handed, stabbing his wife, cutting her up as the boys came through the door. He sits in my car screaming bloody murder that it wasn't him. I think he actually believed it himself. It goes to show, people will up and go mad when they believe their life is over. Oh, I got another good one for you. This one's a little bit less depressing and a bit more hilarious, if I do say so.
Watch out!
This other time...
anybody up there? Shoot, okay? Ah! Hello? I'm not an intruder. Or one of them. These people might need more help than I do.
Thank you. Did you kill it? It's okay. I think she was a monster.
I think so too. You've been all by yourself through this.
Yeah, I want my parents to come home now.
I think that might be a little while, you know?
Oh.
Look, I don't know what happened, but I'll look after you until then.
What should we do now?
This neighborhood is not safe. We're less likely to be seen if we move at night.
My parents might come home.
We won't go far. We'll try to find shelter and come back here with others.
That sounds good. But we can hide in my treehouse until then.
It'll be a tough climb with this leg, but that's a good idea. Let's go. Stay close to me. Stay quiet. We'll head out to the front yard and follow the road out of the neighborhood.
Okay.
It'll be okay. Stay near me, and we'll move as fast as we can.
Things?
Neither of us are.
Oh, damn, you've got a little girl. We're sorry about that. Well, Andre's sorry about that.
It's Officer Mitchell.
My name's Sean. Sean Green. This is Andre.
Officer Mitchell.
Did you see any of those things? One of them just got our buddy Chet.
I saw a lot in the forest, but that was a while ago.
Yeah, one we're looking for is still in the neighborhood.
Oh, shit. You hurt your leg pretty bad. Look, help us find the thing that got our buddy, and we'll take you and your daughter down to my dad's farm to safety. You should be able to fix your leg up, too.
I'm not a dad. I'm her babysitter. Her parents are out of town.
Whoever you are, let's get a move on.
We just were...
Oh, shit. It's Chet.
Let's go. Get to my car. Go.
Say hi to your dad.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Sean. Chet was a good dude.
One of the best.
Take care of you two.
too.
Been quiet as usual the past couple days. Well, Brecken down the way thinks his mare's gone lame, but that ain't nothing new.
I ran into Andre outside of Atlanta, and, Chet, he got killed.
No, you're kidding.
Those things got him. Dad, I don't know what's going on.
I'm sorry, Sean. You've brought a couple guests.
Your boy's a lifesaver.
Glad he could be a help to somebody. So it's just you and your daughter, then?
Oh, not his daughter. He's the babysitter.
Honey, do you know this man?
Yes.
Okay, then. Well, looks like you hurt your leg pretty bad there.
Yeah, it's not doing so good.
I can help you out. Sean, run on in and check on your sister. You take a seat up on the porch and I'll go see what I have. Let's have a look. Yeah, this is swollen to hell.
It hurts like hell.
I bet it does. What did you say your name was?
It's Lee.
Nice to meet you, Lee. I'm Herschel Green. How'd this happen?
Car accident.
That's so. Where are you headed before the car accident?
I was getting out of Atlanta.
The news says stay.
Yeah, well, that's a mistake. We hit a guy. One of those things you've been hearing about. On the road.
Who are you with, the girl?
I was with a police officer. He was giving me a ride.
Awful nice of him.
I'm an awful nice guy.
House is full up with mine. We got another displaced family of three sleeping in the barn. You and your daughter are welcome to rest there. We're done here. I didn't get your name, darling.
Clementine.
Can't imagine what you've been through, Clementine.
I'm looking after her until we find her parents.
Hey, Dad. So I'm thinking, first thing tomorrow, we gotta reinforce the fence around the farm.
But what happened to your friend? Maybe that's not a bad idea.
It smells like...
Get up.
I'm itchy.
Well, you slept in a barn, little lady. Lucky you don't have spiders in your hair. But I bet your daddy scared them all away, huh?
I'm, not her dad. Name's Lee.
I'm Kenny.
Dad, we're in the middle of a fence. There's a tractor and everything.
We better get going, or we won't hear the end of it. That's my boy, Ken Jr. We call him Duck, though.
Dodging or quacking?
Quacking.
Dad!
See? The word is, you were on your way to Macon.
My family's from there.
Well, Macon's on the way, and personally, I'd appreciate the company of a guy who can knock a couple of heads together if he has to.
I'll see what the girl would like.
Ah, gotta consult the missus. I understand. Honey, Doug, this is Lee. And, what's the girl's name?
Clementine.
Clementine.
That is a very pretty name.
Thanks.
Well, we should get to work. We've all seen what those things can do out there, so the faster we get this fence up, the better.
I want to build a fence.
Yeah? Well, I need a good foreman. You can sit on the tractor and yell at me whenever I take a water break.
On the tractor? Cool!
Duck and I will hop to it.
I can keep an eye on your little girl here on the porch. We can visit.
Hey there, girls. You two actually look relaxed.
I think we're doing just fine. Clementine was just telling me about first grade.
Oh, how's that?
It's easy.
Well, yeah. So, you're good?
Anyway, it's almost like we didn't see people eating each other for the past 3 days. It's peaceful.
So, what do you do when corpses aren't walking around?
I'm a veterinarian back in Fort Lauderdale, like Herschel here, except more with dogs and cats and not horses. What is it that you do, Lee?
I used to teach up at the University of Georgia.
We need to hope that we can go back to our jobs soon, Lee. Back to normal. It can't stay like this. Soon.
How did you handle getting through the city?
Kenny just drove. We passed so many people that needed help, and we just passed people over some.
It's okay. It's fine. You don't have to say anymore.
I want to go home tomorrow, but even then I can't take away the things Doc went through. Don't you want to go back to the moment before he knew about all of this?
Anybody in their right mind would. Families and barbecues and beers with good friends.
All of those things.
Those are the things we live for, right? With those gone, what's the point? Back in a bit.
Okay, Lee.